Let's say that we're given a frequency distribution table and we want to find the variance and standard deviation for this group data. The formula for finding the sample variance for group data is S squared equals N times the quantity, sum of the quantity frequency times XM squared, minus the sum of the frequency times XM quantity squared, divided by N times N minus 1. In this equation, S squared equals the sample variance. N equals the total frequency, or the total number of values in the data set. F equals the frequency for a given class. XM equals the midpoint for a given class. And this symbol is the capital Greek letter sigma, and it means sum of. And the standard deviation would then be the square root of this formula. So basically we need to find five things. N, the total number of values in the data set, XMs, the midpoints of each of the classes, the XM squared, or the midpoint squared for each class, Fs times the XMs, and Fs times the XM squared. The fastest and easiest way to approach this problem is to create some more columns in our table. We're going to add in column 3, and it's going to be the midpoint, XM, of each of the classes. Column 4 is going to be the midpoints of each class squared, XM squared. Column 5 is going to be F times XM, the frequencies of the class times the midpoints of the class. And column 6 is going to be F times XM squared, the frequency of each class times the midpoint squared of each class. Next, we need to calculate the midpoint for each of the classes. And the formula to do this is class midpoint equals the lower class limit plus the upper class limit divided by 2. So for class 1, we have 126 plus 174, which equals 300. Divide by 2, and we get 150 as the midpoint for class 1. Class 2 is 175 plus 223 divided by 2, which equals 199. And you would continue this process and fill in column 3 as you see here. Next, we're going to fill in column 4, the midpoint of each class squared. So for the first class, we have a midpoint of 150. Square that, and we get 22,500. For class 2, we have 199. Square that, and we get 39,601. And you would continue this process and fill in column 4 as you see here. Now we have what we need for columns 5 and 6. For column 5, we have the frequency for each class times the midpoints for each class. So for class 1, we have a frequency of 5 times a midpoint of 150, which equals 750. For class 2, we have a frequency of 5 times a midpoint of 199, which equals 995. And you would continue this process for the remaining classes as you see in the table. Next, we have column 6, the frequency for each class times the midpoint squared for each class. So for class 1, we have a frequency of 5 and a midpoint squared of 22,500. Multiply those and we get 112,500. For class 2, we have a frequency of 5 and a midpoint squared of 39,601. Multiply those and we get 198,005. And again, you would continue this process for the remaining classes as you see in the table. Now we can total up the frequencies from column 2, which equals 75, which is our N value. We total up column 5, the frequencies times the midpoints, and we get 21,442. Then we total up column 6, the frequencies times the midpoint squared, and we get 6,440,206. Now we have everything we need to plug into the equation. We plug in 75 for each N in the equation. On the top, we plug in 6,440,206 for the sum of the quantity frequency times XM squared. And we plug in 21,442 for the sum of the frequency times XM. Next, we do our computations, as you see on the screen, which eventually lead to an answer of 4,190.3 as S squared, or the variance for the group data. And to get S, or the standard deviation, we simply take the square root of the variance, which equals 64.7. And now we have our variance and standard deviation for the group data. All right, my friends, hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.